Do you see that? There's nothing there. I want you to imagine what it's like to be discriminated about your hair type or your hair texture. It's definitely not a nice thought, is it? In this documentary, we talk to some of our interviewees about problems they have faced with their hair types and what they also love about their natural hair. But first, let's take a look at some amazing hairstyles black people have had before. My daddy made it up, out of the ghetto. Believe in your dreams, believe you and me, don't let go. We're living it up, we're having a good time, baby. I was born uptown, now the ghetto dream, now ain't life crazy. Daddy made it up. Now wasn't that something amazing? Let's talk to some of our interviewees about their hair, starting with their discrimination stories.
Okay, so I think the discrimination word is, it's a heavy word, but I think it can be borderline, and I think it's how you recognise it. So at work, for instance, they will always say to me, oh, you're always changing your hair. Okay, because I can. And I would say that's discrimination, but it is pointed out. And maybe in their eyes, they're not even trying to discriminate, or they're not even aware of what they're doing, do you know what I mean? And it may be a compliment, so I take it as a compliment. I don't allow people to touch my hair. We good, but don't touch my hair.
I hope you got that. Don't touch Anne-Marie's hair.
Hair discrimination, yes, I experienced it among my own people. But yeah, that was when I came to this country, and I didn't know nothing, because I grew up in Germany for like 14 years. So when I came here, people were telling me what products I need to use, how I should treat my hair, which I had no idea of. And they used to like make fun of my hair, the way my hair looks, that I never comb my hair, you know what I'm saying? I never used to comb my hair anyways, because I love my hair messy.
Now that we have heard some of their struggles and stories about being discriminated, on a brighter note, let's see why they love their hair and how they describe it.
Suits me. Only hair I like really is like long hair. Can't have it like bald.
Describe my hair in three words, as in strength, beauty, and roots. Reason why? Beautiful, because aesthetically pleasing. And it's looking, every black hair is immaculate. The other one is strength. It just shows your heritage, where you come from. That's hence why roots interlink together. So yeah, but for me, I just love my hair as it is, because it shows my personality and where I'm coming from.
My crown, which is my beauty. I believe every black woman's hair is their beauty. So. It's my crown. Second word I want to say is versatile. My crown is so versatile. As much as I like to keep up with trends and things, I know I can switch it up. I can switch my hair and change my hair within a matter of hours, days. So sometimes every month I've got a different hairstyle. Sometimes people don't recognise me because my hair is always changing.
It's always interesting to see why and how people love their hair the way it is. As we near the end of this documentary, we asked our interviewees one last question. Where do they see black hair going and looking like in the future?
Okay, so I think for a long time, for years, centuries, I think black hair is the lead in the way anyway. I think with the styles that we do, we are trendsetters. You see all kind of cultures copying styles that black hair has originated, braiding, cornrows, plaits, and now you see all kind of cultures wearing those types of styles, both young and old, famous and infamous.
I see black hair in the future, like, I'd say a lot of people are getting locks. The reason I'm saying this is because lately, like when I started my lock journey, I've been seeing a lot of people, I've come across a lot of people that have locks, and I'm like, rah, mad. Even people that I know, people that I engage with, they have locks, and I'm like, ooh, your locks look hard. And then, more natural hair as well, like either locks or natural hair, because I think I'm not for artificial hair, just saying, because I love my naturalness. And
we would like to say a special thank you to our interviewees for participating in our documentary. But before we leave you, here is a poem written by Ka-charian and the evolution of female black hair over this last century. So now you've watched and seen our hair documentary, I hope you take away this. It's never just hair as you see. Braids, plaits, dreads, kinks and curls, waves and coils, afro, weave, silk press. With our hair we express, with our hair we impress, with our hair we distress. I actually wrote this whilst at the hairdresser, and it was a pleasure having my hair done so perfect and neat. On my barber, I'll never cheat.